Hello, welcome to this Touch Designer tutorial. Today we're going to learn how to use the machine learning model Mediapipe, which was made by Torin Blankenschmidt and Dom Scott, to get the data from one finger. Here it is the tip of the middle finger that I'm using. So we're going to see how we can use that data. Let's get started. So I'm gonna start from scratch by deleting everything. So let's do that. The first thing you're gonna do is you're gonna head on to your browser and go to the link I set in the description. Here you can download this release zip. So in there you will get these components. So we're gonna start by dragging and dropping this Mediapipe component here inside the project, and the hand tracking. Once that's done, you can close this. So we're gonna need this component saved on our computer, because it will every time you will open the project, it's gonna have to be rebooted. So what you're gonna do is press P if you haven't done that to open the parameters, and you're gonna uncheck all the checkboxes here except for the hands, because we only need the hands. And once you've done that, you can go to your palette here, and inside one of your folders you can just drag and drop this one. Let's rename it hands, like this, and drag and drop in here. So it's gonna take a while. Once you've done that, we can add a null chop from this from the second one here. So here we have all the data from our hands appearing, but we only need the tip of the fingers. So I'm gonna show you how to do that. Let's dive into the hand tracking component and delete, let's close this, and delete all this. We don't need the sub geometries here. You can just reorder this here, like this. And we're gonna dive into the first hand and slide this across here. So you're gonna want to insert a select. So let's create a select, and we are gonna choose one of the channels. So just put your hand in front of the camera. Here you can see all the channels corresponding to your left hand or one hand, and we're interested in the middle finger tip, which is the 13th of the list. So here inside the select we can add channel 13, like this, and inside the rename you can go here and just try to find the middle finger tip by like selecting, going to, let's find it, here it is. So H1 middle finger tip X, copy that, Control C, and then we can just press here, Control A, delete all, and paste it. So now we are only selecting the X fingertip, and we're gonna do the same for the Y and Z. So just duplicate the select, change it here. It's the same channel, it's channel 13. So just copy and paste, and then in the rename, you can just, we don't need to select it again, you just need to delete all, insert this line, and change the X to Y. Same goes for the Z, just like that. So now we have those three values, but we also need to change one thing. So we're gonna add a constant, and this constant we're gonna call it middle fingertip X. That's perfect. Create another one. This one is gonna be Y, and the third one is gonna be Z, like this. And we can delete that default value thing and change it with our own. So rename this chop just like that, default values. So now we have those three values here. We're gonna do the exact same thing for the second hand. So just slide across, create a select, select channel 13. Then just copy and paste. Oops, just like that. And here we can just copy all, select all and delete it, and change the H1 to H2 like this. So copy this now and do the same for the rest. Change it to Y, and this one change it to Z. So now if you put both of your hands up in the air, it should appear. If you only have one hand in the air, it won't show up because it's two hands detection. So now we have the second hand, and we're gonna do the same here. We are gonna create a constant, insert this, and again, change it to Y, change it to Z, and replace that here, and you can delete that. So now if we go back and we put both our hands up in the air, we have the data of our middle finger. See, now I'm just changing the Y position. Now we have that. We can delete all of that, we don't need that actually. Just like this. So we can head out now, and as you can see, we have this data, and practically you can use that data for anything you want now. I mean, you can use it on the previous particle system we created if you want. I'm also gonna do a sound project with that very soon, but for this tutorial I want to keep it simple, and we're just gonna create like a simple circle top. And in order to see the hand, in order to see the position of the finger. So change the radius of this circle to 0.01. Go to the common page, change the resolution to something you want. And from here, from the Mediapipe component, we're gonna insert a flip. I'm gonna flip X. And we're gonna insert a fit, and fit is also gonna be the same resolution as the circle. So now we can merge these together with a comp, insert a composite, and add this together. So now what we will do is that we will adjust the data that we have here, because it's raw normalized data. So what we will do is create select, and we're gonna copy and paste it six in total. So you're gonna select the first one here, second one there, third one here, etc. like this. I'm gonna change the color just to make things more clear, because the blue is one hand and the red is the second hand. So here we're gonna add a mat, and you can just copy and paste that as well. Oops. Just like that. And in order to get the data again, we need to create another select, which is gonna collect all of these again. And just to make things a little more clean, add a null chop and rename it to hands. So these are the values we're gonna use. Here in the math, you will change the channel pre-op to negate this fourth one as well. And in the multi-add, we are gonna set it to -0.5 in the post-add, sorry, and the fourth one as well. Sorry, it's actually 0.5 and not -0.5. Yes. And in the Y, we're gonna change it to -0.5. Just like that. So now we can make this active, and inside the circle, we will use the X on the center and the Y on this one. And you can duplicate this circle now and insert and drag and drop the fourth value here on the second circle, just like that. So now these two are going here and these two are going there, and we are gonna combine this all together. So yeah, just feel free to add this circle inside the comp, it doesn't really matter. And from there, we're gonna do a null, which we are gonna call BG, and we're gonna turn the viewer on. So now when I show my hands, you can see the point is right on the tip of my middle finger. And we also want to change the Z, the size of the circle. So for that, we are gonna, actually, we're gonna just add 0.05 in here, in the multi-add, post-add, 0.05, excuse me, like this, 0.05. So we can drag this in the radius of the first one, and this one in the radius of the second one. So now when I move back, it changes its size, as you can see. So that's what I wanted to show you for this tutorial. Of course, we could have used the wrist, we could have used other points, but I think the middle finger is interesting, because if I can't really move back, but it kind of shows on top of the hand, and that's what I'm interested in if I want to create a particle system, for example. So that's what we're gonna use. So that's it for this tutorial. I hope this component will be useful to you. It is definitely useful to me. And I think everyone can use that. So it's really interesting, really powerful. Of course, it's still under development. Torin and Dom are doing a great work. They just released the 3.3 version. But there are certain things you need to know. The first thing is that every time you close your project, the Mediapipe component will not be, when you reopen your project, it will not work. You need to, that's why we added this into our palette here. So when you open your project again, you just delete this one, just delete the main Mediapipe component, and you drag and drop the Mediapipe hands that we created together here. And the second thing you need to know is that in order to only have the video device without the green and red dots that you see here, if we only wanted the white circles, let's say, we need to use something called Spout and create like a virtual camera using siphon spout out. So I will demonstrate that in another tutorial. For the moment, this is pretty fine. We don't always need the camera, but it might become handy to do that another time. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me. I'm available all the time. Yeah, I think that's it for this tutorial. Thank you for following along, and see you in the next one.